Okay, hello everyone. Myself, A. Ritika Reddy, working as an assistant professor in Vignan's Institute of Information and Technology, Visakhapatnam. In this current semester, I am going to deal the subject discrete mathematical structures. Till now, you already have an introduction session conducted by Vishwanath Sharma sir. In this session now, I am going to introduce you what are sets and combinatorics. Sets and combinatorics is the unit one of this discrete mathematics subject. So, let us see, firstly, in this sets and combinatorics, what are the contents which I am going to introduce. First comes sets and subsets. What are these we are going to see. Next comes the Venn diagrams and set operations. The next is the laws of set theory. And the next is the counting principle. Okay, we will go into further definition of a set. So, a set is a well-defined, unordered collection of distinct elements of same type. What is unordered? Unordered means the order of the thing doesn't matter. Like if you keep in a set like 1, 2, 3 or 3, 2, 1, both mean the same. Here the order doesn't matter. And this 1, 2, 3 and 3, 2, 1, these are integers. So they should be of same type and they should be distinct. Like if you should not keep like 1, 2, 2. That doesn't come into the set, they should not be the same. Okay. Next, in general, a set is denoted by a capital letter and the elements which are present inside the set are separated by commas and they are ended by a flowerly braces. See, in this example, if you can see the example over here, here A is called as a set. It is denoted by the capital numbers, capital letter. And here 5, 7, 9, 11, these are called as the set elements. And these elements are separated by commas and enclosed by the flowerly braces. This is one of the ways of representation of a set. There are many other ways of representation of a set. In computer science, sets are used in various fields. For example, if we take data structures, set plays a very important role in data structures because in order to search an element inside a data structure, it will be taking a lots of time. But instead, if you want to divide into, if you can divide into sets, then the thing becomes easy. Suppose in a class of 60 students, if I want to search the name Pavani. So in order to search Pavani, I have to filter every student. But if I divide Pavani, as after listening the name Pavani, the thing will come, okay, she might be a girl. So first I need to divide into two sets. One is the girls and the other one is the boys. And in girls also, I need to filter the names which are starting with the letter P. So it will be very easy for me in order to search the word, the name Pavani, if I divide the structure into sets. In the same way, there are numerous number of fields in which sets can be applied. And here, as I said, this is one of the representation of a set. In the similar way, there are many ways. And okay, see, there are mainly three ways of representation of a set. The first comes is the statement form and descriptive form. The second comes is the roster form and the tabular form or the tabular form. The third is the set builder form. What are these and what are the examples of these? We will be looking now. See, statement form. Here, a single statement describes all the elements inside a set. Like I have shown in the previous example, see here V is there. V denotes the set of vowels. Like here, one second. Here, this V alone represents the set of vowels. Like set of real numbers are denoted by R or set of integers are denoted by Z. So, in the statement form, in order to represent a particular elements, you need to represent in the form of a single letter. Okay. Next comes the roster form. In this form, the members of the given set are enlisted within the pair of braces and separated by commas. As I said in the previous example, this is the representation which you have seen in the previous example. And suppose if you are given a statement and asked you to write in the form of a set, then it will be like, see, this is the statement which you are given. The set of all even whole numbers between 1 to 10. So here we are given a range and we have given a condition. The condition is they should be even numbers. as they should be even numbers and they should be represented in a roster form. So the even numbers between 1 to 10 are 2, 4, 6, 8. If only 10 is not included, if at all we are given a condition like 10 should also be included, then the list will also be 10 also should be included in that set. Okay. Next is the set builder form. In set builder form, what happens is that a property related to that set is enlisted for you, and based on the property, you need to find the elements of that set. For suppose here I am given a property like there is an x such that x is positive integers between 10 to 20. It is similar to roster form, but the representation is different because over here the condition is mentioned in this way. Firstly, it is opened by flower braces followed by this variable followed by the condition which is related to the variable. Here x is a variable and the condition to which represent the set is like x should be between 10 to 20. So the set will be like from 10, 11, 12, so on up to 20. Okay, this is the set builder form. Okay, next comes the types of sets. Till now we have seen the representation of sets, the definition of set, and how sets can be used in one of the field of computer science. Now we will see the types of sets. See, the first is the empty set or null set. The second one is the singleton set. The third is the equal set. The fourth is the equivalent set. Next is the finite set followed by the infinite set. And the next one is the proper subset, and the next one is the superset. These are the different types of subsets. We will be looking into one by one. See, first comes the empty set. A set which does not contain any element is called as an empty set or null set or void set, or it is denoted by this is the denotation of the empty set. See, if at all I don't have any elements in a set, it is called as an empty set. Okay. See, here this is the set builder notation for which is given for me. I am asked to find whether it is an empty set or not. So here A is equal to x colon 2 less than x less than 3, and x is a natural number. As we already know, natural numbers doesn't exist in the form of fractions, and there is no natural number which is present between 2 and 3, because the numbers which are existing between the 2 and 3 numbers are fractions only. So the set which is the number of elements which we get from here will be null. So that's case, this A is called as the null set. Next, singleton set. See, a set which contains only one element is called as a singleton set. Here one element means the entire set should contain only one element, that's it. Here A is equal to 2, this is a singleton set, followed by A is equal to x colon, x is neither prime nor composite. It is a singleton set because 1 is the only number in the entire number system, 1 is the only number which is neither prime nor composite. So here this is also a singleton set, followed by the finite set. A set which contains a definite number of elements is called as a finite set. Here the example which I am forecasting is the set of colors in a rainbow. As we know, the rainbow contains 7 colors, which is Wibgeor. So no one can come and edit that set because they are fixed elements. Hence it is called as a finite set. Next comes the infinite set. The set whose elements cannot be listed, that is a set containing ever ending elements, is called as the infinite set. So the example which I am forecasting here is that set of all points in a plane, or set of numbers which is greater than 1. Suppose I am given a plane and I am asked to point the points over it, there will be infinite number because we can point many things on a plane. In a similar way, the number of the numbers which are greater than 1 is also infinite because we don't know what is the ending number of the natural numbers. Okay, this is the infinite set. Next is the proper subset. The proper subset of a set is a subset of A that is not equal to A. We will understand this through this one more statements. In other words, if B is a proper subset of A, that is, see here B is a proper subset of A. That means B contains the elements which are present in A, but B doesn't contain some elements which are present in A. That means A contains at least one element which is not present in B. In that case, it is called as the proper subset. Next. And see, this is the example which I am showing. Here A is equal to 135 and B is equal to 15. Then in that case, here B is called as the proper subset of A, because A contains one element which is 3. 3 is not contained in B. So B is called as the proper subset of A. Now we will understand what is superset. Okay, a set A is a superset of another set B if all the elements of set B are the elements of set A. It is similar to the proper subset. That is, I have viewed this set from the angle of B. But if I view this set from the angle of A, if B is called as the proper subset, then A is called as the superset, and it is denoted in this. This is the way of denoting a super subset. Like A is a super subset of B. See, if at all A is equal to 15 and B is equal to 135, then in that case B is called as the superset of A. Okay. Next, equal sets. Equal sets are nothing but if two sets are given to us and if all the elements of the two sets are equal in that, along with their cardinality. Okay, one more thing, cardinality. What is cardinality? Cardinality is nothing but the number of elements present. It is used to denote the count of elements present in a set. For suppose A contains 1, 2, 3, then the number of elements present in A will be 3 and the cardinality of A will be 3. See, this is the notation for denoting cardinality. See, this is the notation of denoting cardinality. And now let us come back to equal sets. Equal sets have the exact elements in them, even though they are unordered. Here order doesn't matter, but the only thing which matters is their cardinality and their elements should be same. See, here A is equal to 1, 2, 3, B is equal to 3, 1, 2, and C is equal to 2, 1, 3. Here the number of elements are same, but the order is not same. But for according to the definition of equal set, the cardinality should be same and the number element should be same. So these are equal sets. Next, followed by the equivalent sets. See, in this equal set we have seen like the even though the order doesn't matter, the number of elements should be same. But when come to equivalent set, even though elements are not same, if the cardinality is the same, then it is called as the equivalent sets. Okay. Once I'll say it in the form of definition. Equivalent set have different elements but have the same cardinality. Cardinality is defined as the number of elements present in the set. Okay. And the symbol which is used for denoting equivalent set is this one. This is the symbol which is denoted for equivalent sets. And here is the example. Here in this example, A is given as 1, 2, 3 and the cardinality of A is 3 and B is equal to PQR and the cardinality of B is 3. Therefore, A and B are equivalent. According to the definition of equivalent set, A and B are equivalent to each other. Now, till now we have learned different types of sets. Okay. Now let us look into the set operations. See, you are given two sets, that is well and good. Then what you are going to with these two sets? Are you going to add them or are you going to difference them, and what are you getting from those two sets? That we can understand in the set operations. Here there are four kinds of set operations which you can perform. First, union, intersection, complement and difference. See, let us understand the definitions of this with the example which is stated over here. Here firstly I am given a universal set like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, universal set. What is universal set? Universal, what is universe? Universe is something which contains everything. Similar way, a universal set, when constrained to this particular thing, it is called as the, when constrained to this particular thing, if it contains all the elements, then it is called as a universal set. Here set A and set B, there are two sets. All the elements present in set A and set B are present in U. So universal set contains the entire elements which are relating to that problem. For suppose we are given this universal set which contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there is another set A which contains the elements 1, 2. And another set B which contains element 2, 3, 4. So, if at all I am asked to perform a set operation union. What is union? It is the combination of two sets. Like if I want to find the union of two sets, then I have to combine all the elements of those two sets and display the result. I will explain this in the form of definition. Wait a second. See, the union of two sets is a set of elements that belong to one or both of the two sets. That means if I am given like a set A, see here a set A and set B are given. Set A contains 1, 2 and set B contains 2, 3, 4. If I am asked to do the union of these elements, then the union operation here will contain the elements that is 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, it contains common elements and individual elements present in that set. This is the union operation. Next comes the intersection operation. Intersection is nothing but taking only the common elements and displaying those common elements. Same two sets are given, set A and set B. If I am asked to find the intersection of both, then what will be the intersection? 2. 2 is the only element which comes after the intersection. And here A intersection B which you are getting is a singleton set, as I have said in the definition. As it contains only one element, this is a singleton set. Okay, this is the intersection operation, and these are the symbols which are used to represent the union and intersection. This is the union operation and this is the intersection operation. And the other set operations which you will be seeing is the complement. Complement is nothing but, first suppose in this example, one second, in this previous examples, if you are given this universal set and you are asked to find the complement of, one second, suppose this one is given for you and you are asked to find the B complement. That means here B is given as 2, 3, 4. Then what will be B complement? Complement is nothing but the elements that are not from that set. They should be outside that set. If you are taking this example and if you are given this B is equal to 2, 3, 4 and you are asked to find the complement, in that case the number of elements which are present in the complement will be 1, 5. These are the two elements which are present in the complement of the set. Okay. I'll say the definition now. The complement of an event is a set of all elements in the universal space but not in the event. Everything is matched, right, according to the example and the definition. Next, set difference. The difference between sets is denoted by A difference B. What is set difference? Something which are not part of that one. Difference, common definition is it should not be part of that one. And a difference between sets is denoted by A difference B. Is the set that containing elements of set A but not in B. That is, all elements of A except the elements of B. Suppose I am given the set like A is equal to 1, 2, 1, 3, 4 and B is equal to 2. In that case, if I am asked to find A difference B, then the elements should be only from A but not from B. It should be like 1, here sorry it is 3, it should be like 1, 4. Because 3 is present in A, I should not include A and I should not include 3 and I should include only 1, 4. This is the set difference operation. Okay, till now we have, this is a summary of the lecture. I will be just saying you what are the topics which we have discussed till now. First one is the definition of set. we have seen what is a set and how a set can be represented. We have seen the representation of sets and what are the different ways of representing a set. Followed by the types of sets, we have seen all different types of sets like equal set, equivalent set, finite sets and many other. And the fourth one which we have encountered is the set operations. If we are given two sets and if we are asked to find something about that set, then those can be accomplished with these set operations. Okay, thank you.